this video, we're going to look at another one of my favorite new features with macOS Sonoma, widgets. We can now add widgets to our Mac. We can add them to our desktop on the Mac, much like we can with the iPad and iPhone. Not only can we add widgets to our desktop, but we can also add widgets from our iPhone to the Mac. So if there's an app, like in my case, I have a Tesla. The Tesla app is not available on the Mac. Well, now what I'm able to do is add the Tesla widget from my iPhone to the Mac. Let's see how this works. Let's go over to my Mac. Let's first look at how we add widgets to our Mac. All we need to do is just get to our contextual menu. What is our contextual menu? Well, we hold down the control key and we click. We click with the trackpad or we click with the mouse. When I hold down the control key and click, we have a menu that pops up. This is our contextual menu. Under our contextual menu, you're going to see we have Edit Widgets. This also allows me to add widgets. Now, I am using a beta version of macOS Sonoma, so this could change, the wording could change with the final release. But basically, what we need to do is we need to edit our widgets, and then when we edit it, it also allows us to add widgets. So you're going to see that I have all of my widgets here, and all I have to do is just find the widgets that I want, and I drag them to my desktop. That's how easy it is. So let's go and add a couple of widgets here. We're going to go with one of my favorite, the weather app. So I'm going to swipe up. We're going to go over to weather. We can see we have different sizes. I just click and drag, and it places it on my desktop. That's my favorite way. We can also click on a plus here to add it. Let's go and add another one. We're going to go with the reminders app here, and I'm going to click on the plus here, and we can see that it adds it to my desktop. We're going to go with the calendar app. Click on it. And this time we're going to go with a little smaller one, and I like to use my favorite way of doing that is drag and drop. Now, I mentioned that we could also add widgets from our iPhone. If we go over to my iPhone here, you're going to see that I have the Tesla app. This Tesla app is not available on the Mac. With the Mac, we can install some iPhone apps. So in this case here, we can install the Tesla app. So I can't actually control my Tesla from my Mac. Well, what I can do, the Tesla app does have a widget. So I'm going to tap and hold here on my phone. We're going to go to the plus here, and you're going to see that when I swipe up and I go over to Tesla, I do have a couple of widgets that are available. I can add these widgets to my Mac. In order to do that, all we have to do is just go back over to our Mac. We really don't have to do anything on the iPhone. You're going to see that I have, when I swipe up, Tesla. And there are the two widgets. If I wanted to add this to my Mac, all I would have to do is just click and drag and place it where I want. So in addition to adding widgets from various apps on our Mac, we can also add them from the iPhone here. All right, so now I've added these widgets. What else can we do? Well, when we click on them, of course, they will open up that app. I click on it, it opens up the weather app. I'm going to quit out of here. I click on the calendar, it opens up the calendar app. I click on reminders, it'll open up the reminders app. But in addition to that, they are interactive. What do I mean by interactive? Well, if we go to the reminders app here, you're going to see that it says all reminders completed. Well, they actually aren't. If I go over to my reminders app here, you're going to see that I have a list called macOS Sonoma, and I have three different reminders on there. The reason why they do not show here is this is all of the reminders that are completed that are due. Those reminders aren't due. What I'm able to do is change what is shown on these widgets. I can actually edit a widget. We can do the same thing on the iPad and iPhone. How do we do that? We just control click on the widget and you're going to see edit reminders. So you're going to see that I have my inbox shown. So every reminder in my inbox is completed. That's why it says it's empty. But if we go over to my macOS Sonoma features and I click on done, we can see that I have three reminders that are not done. And it has the number three here. Now, when I go and click on any one of these to complete it, it does not actually have to open up the reminders app. This is the interactive part of it. When I click on widgets here, the number three is going to go down to a number two. It's going to disappear. And we're going to have two reminders left, and it will not open up the reminders app. This is the interactive part of it. So I'm going to click on it. We can see that it disappears, and we have a number two here. Let's go ahead and click on it again. It disappears, and now we have just one reminder left. And this is also available on the iPad and iPhone with iPadOS 17 and iOS 17. Now, if we want to change the size, we can do that as well. Remember that the calendar app had a number of different sizes. I want to make this a little bit larger. How can I do that? Well, basically, all I have to do is just hold down the control key and I click, and you're going to see I have all of my different sizes here. So let's go ahead and make this extra large. We're going to make this as big as it can be. And we can see it's taken up quite a bit of my desktop there. So let's go ahead and make it a little bit smaller. I control click, medium, and now it is medium size. To move them around, we just click and drag and we can move it around. They do snap to a grid, but we do have a little bit more flexibility than we do on the iPad and iPhone. I can place them in between different widgets. I can place it to the right as we saw, and I can place it at the bottom. On the iPad and iPhone, we do not have that much flexibility. It kind of controls where they are. On the Mac, I can actually control where they go. To remove a widget, we just control click on it again, and then you're going to see remove widget. Now, when we open up a window, what it will do is it'll make the widget go into a monochrome. It's going to take on the background color. Let's go ahead and open up a Safari window here. And you're going to see that the widgets kind of took on the background color. This is the monochrome color. This allows us to focus on our active window without having our widget kind of stare at us in the face. Now, if you like this monochrome color permanently, you can do that as well. When we go back over to my wallpaper here, you're going to see that it brings them back nice and bright. Well, if you want to have them that monochrome color, you can do that as well. We can even turn these off. To do that, what we do is we go to our system settings, and then we go over to our desktop and dock, and you're going to see an option to show widgets. If I do not want to see them, all I have to do is just click on this, and we can see that they disappeared. Click on it again, it brings them back. I don't have to re-add them when I turn it off and then turn it back on. It remembers what widgets I had, so I just turn it back on, and there they are again. Now, in addition to that, if I swipe up, you're going to see that I also can change the style. Right now, it is set to automatic, which means it's going to change from automatic to the bright full color, depending on if there's a window in front of it. In this case here, I have a window in front, so they're monochrome. Well, if I want to make them monochrome all the time, I can do that. And now, even when I click on the desktop here, we can see that they do not change color. I can also make them full color all the time. We can see that, even though I'm working within a window here, they are full color. I don't think that one's going to be used that often. I'm going to leave it at automatic. I like to have automatic. And then we can also set if we want to be able to use iPhone widgets or not. So that's how we work with widgets on the Mac. This is definitely something that I'm going to be using, particularly with apps on my iPhone that are not available on the Mac. They do have widgets that are available. So what I'm able to do is actually work with that app on a limited basis, but I'm actually able to work with that app on my Mac through its widget. So that's how we work with widgets on the Mac with macOS Sonoma.